Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, I will show you how to enable MCP in your self-hosted n8n setup and walk you through building a simple event-driven AA agent using the MCP server trigger and MCP client nodes. You might be hearing about MCP all over. I will share basic details about MCP based on my understanding and how to set it up in n8n. And I will demo a real-time workflow to bring it all together. What is MCP? Model Context Protocol. Model Context Protocol, or MCP, is an open standard that defines how AI agents and language models interact with external tools, data sources, and services. MCP enables a structured, event-driven request-response mechanism that allows models to discover, invoke, and exchange context with external systems. Before MCP, each application followed its own integration approaches for connecting with external systems, which complicated the integration efforts and also impacted the interoperability. Key features: standardized communication enables seamless interaction between agents, tools, and LLMs. Event-driven supports structured request response over various transports, example stdio, http over sse. Stdio for local communications and http over server sent events for remote communication. Modular and scalable, easily extend AI capabilities by plugging in new tools via MCP servers. Interoperable, designed to work across different AI platforms and environments. Why MCP? This standardizes communication between tools, agents, and models, facilitates real-time event-driven AI workflows, bridges AI and software with a shared open protocol, enables modular, scalable, and reusable tool integrations, works across systems like LLMs, APIs, databases, files, memory, and more. Simplifies orchestration of multi-step, multi-tool AI agents. MCP components. The first one is MCP server. MCP server exposes tool capabilities to AI agents, allowing them to interact intelligently with external tools and systems. It also handles event publishing and responses, enabling real-time communication between agents and their environments. Refer to modelcontextprotocol.io/examples to understand more example MCP servers. MCP client. MCP client connects directly to a specific MCP server to enable seamless communication. It is responsible for sending requests such as tool actions or queries and receives structured responses, ensuring smooth interaction between agents and the server-side capabilities. MCP host. MCP host is the AI application layer that manages one or more MCP clients. It coordinates tool usage, handles incoming requests, and ensures the right tools are called at the right time. Example of MCP host are applications like Cloud, Cursor, and n8n, which orchestrate agent interactions efficiently through the setup. MCP transport mechanisms. As we discussed, there are two types, stdio and http over sse. Stdio transport uses standard input output, stdin, stdout, ideal for local tools or CLA based agents. This is common in dev tools like Cursor or Cloud Desktop, simple and secure for local workflows. HTTP plus SSE uses HTTP post from the client to send requests to the server, and server sent events for the server to push real-time streamed responses back to the client. It is ideal for remote tools or services, especially when low latency updates are required. MCP in action. MCP host, that's a AI application slash orchestrator. This manages one or more MCP clients decides when to trigger a request, coordinates tool usage and permission policies. Examples are Claude, Cursor, n8n, and more. MCP client acts as the communication layer between host and server, sends structured requests and handles the responses. This maintains connection with the designated MCP server. MCP server, this interfaces with external tools, services or data sources, executes tasks and returns structured results. This exposes available tool capabilities via schema. If you want to learn more about MCP, refer to the official website modelcontextprotocol.io. MCP support in n8n. n8n recently introduced support for MCP in its latest versions. Let's now see how to enable it in the local setup. We previously discussed the n8n starter kit, which runs n8n with AI tools like Olama and Quadrant in Docker. You can refer to the video. I have posted the video link in description. To enable MCP in your self-hosted n8n, you should add n8n community packages allow tool usage equal to true in your Docker environment config. In my case, I am using n8n starter kit, so I am adding it to the Docker compose.yaml file. As of now, the MCP support is only available through community package for n8n. I am executing Docker compose down to remove all the existing setup. Okay, done. Now you can execute again Docker compose profile CPU up. If you see any issues related to network, so maybe you can come here, Docker desktop, and delete this complete setup. Then rerun this command again. This time it should be success. Okay, now the server is started, localhost 5678. Let me access that. Let us now install the MCP community package. For that, go to this one, then settings. So here you can see community nodes, click on that. I already installed that n8n nodes MCP, but otherwise just that community package, go to install, give the package name, then install. I understand, select that, then install. So this will enable the MCP support for local n8n server. Now if you go back here, now go to, let's say, create a workflow. Now looks for these nodes or components. Now if you type in MCP, you can find two nodes. One is MCP server trigger and MCP client. So what does that mean is n8n can act as a MCP server, also MCP client component can be used. Let us now create a simple event-driven AA agent with MCP. User sends a message to our chat agent asking for Google Calendar events or create new events. AA agent routes the request to an MCP client node. The client connects to a sub workflow running on MCP server trigger. Sub workflow fetches event data or create new Google Calendar event using the API and response to the client. The MCP client in this case connects to a local MCP server running inside n8n, but it can also connect to external MCP servers. Also, MCP server can be accessed externally from other systems. Check out this GitHub repo for more sample MCP servers. This is the sample workflow. Let us start with sub workflow. The sub workflow enabled with MCP server trigger. If I go here, so it has the path you can change as needed. Also, if you want, you can enable authentication. Then it provides test and production URL. You can copy these URLs because we are going to use same URL to connect from MCP client. Then Google Calendar API node. Here two nodes. One is for creating the event, another one is for getting the event details. So if I go here, this is again Google Calendar account 2. I am using the OAuth account created in Google console, developer console. Then you can set some tool description if required. Resources event, get many as the operation. Then like which calendar I'm using my personal ID here. Then you can specify what is the limit here. I'm using defined automatically by the model, but if you want, you can specify. Same thing with after and before date. I'm using the model default here. If you want to add any additional options, you can add it. Next one is to create the event. If I go here, same thing, nothing much different. Again, event operation is create. Here start is, I'm specifying a start variable, default is blank, then string. Then end is, again, end variable, again, string. Also description, event description as the variable, then event title as the variable. Let's move to the main workflow. So here we are using chat message input. If I double click here, I'm enabling this chat public access. So this is the URL to access the chat. Then if I go here, there is this is the initial message, something I'm setting up, that's fine. Now I'm using AI agent node here, same thing, the input. Then again, this is the system message, you are a helpful assistant, current date time is like to format the date. So this looks fine. Now I am connecting OpenAI chat model here. So if I go here, I'm using GPT-4. Then I am using OpenAI account details to connect. Now again, I am using simple memory. So this is optional, you can skip it. Now again, MCP client node. So if I go into MCP client node, so I am using that SSC endpoint, the live URL here, or test URL also, you can use it. Now authentication is blank because we are not enabled with any authentication. Then tools to include, you can select all, means all available tools are used from the server, or you can say selected. So here, if you go here, tools to include, two tools are available because we enable two tools through the server. You can say which tool to select. Also, you can say all except specific tools. If I go here, you can say select whatever the tool you want to exclude, but I'm going with all tools. The workflow is now ready. Let us test. I have activated the workflow. So we'll be using the live URLs for the MCP server trigger and the chat input. Let me start the workflow. So click on test workflow. Okay, now it's fine. Let me create these two events. Please create a Google Calendar event with these details: start date, end, title, title one, description, then description one. Then again, same details, but a different timing and title and description. Let me go and copy this to this live chat URL. If I do that, okay, it has been created now. This is fine. Let me go with the next one. Okay, created. Also, the event link is provided, the Google Calendar event link. You can click here and directly go to the event. So now if I go here and refresh it, okay, if you see here, the event is created. Title 1, 5 p.m. and 6 p.m. This looks good. Let me try to get the event details now. So this is the chat input. Get me the events for today. You can provide any chat input, but I'm going with this. Let me execute this, get me the events for today. I got two events, event one, title one, description one, then the timing, also event two, title two, description two, and the timing. So even you can click here and directly go to the Google event details page. You can extend the workflow based on your need. MCP client can invoke external MCP servers. Also, external MCP clients can invoke MCP trigger service. Thanks for watching. We saw how to enable MCP in a local n8n setup and how it helps create modular event-driven AI workflows. MCP bridges your AI agents with real-world tools using a standardized protocol, and it's only getting more powerful. If you found this helpful, like and subscribe for more deep dives on AI and automation tools and other topics. And don't forget to check the description for resources and links. See you all in the next video.